people sometimes will hold up their phone and they'll say, I have 5G, but what is it really doing for me? And an answer that the industry likes to give is that, well, you can download a movie so much faster than you used to be able to, which I think is a horrible example. Because when's the last time you downloaded a movie to your phone? The answer is almost never. It's like, yeah, when you're about to have an expectation of no connectivity whatsoever or very limited connectivity, which you have to pay for. That's when you download things to your phone, when you're not going to be connected. But we are connected. We're a connected society. And we rely on advances in connectivity to help us do things that we didn't necessarily know that we had to do before. No one knew they wanted ride sharing. No one knew they wanted things like document and real-time collaboration. No one knew they wanted a lot of the things that 4G brought with it. And so right now we're at this place where 4G is kind of, I don't want to say maxed out, but efficient. And where it's not efficient, we're kind of okay with it, right? If we have to wait for Instagram to load for half a second, sure, sometimes if we're being impatient, it bothers us, but it's fine. If we're in a self-driving car that's moving 90 miles an hour and wants to change lanes, and it takes a couple of seconds to buffer, we're okay with that. Are we? No, we're not. There are things that we don't know that we want to do yet, or that we think we might want to do, where something like advanced connectivity, like 5G, it's really going to become crucial.